Hello everyone. So today I am going to talk about generating ideas before making a design. I am going to make a dog design today. So as we know that dogs are really, police use dogs for detecting criminals like with their smell. So dogs are like detectives. So I have a plan in mind that I will make a detective looking dog, and this is a pit bull dog. So I need to make some, like I'm going to make this design in my way. So I need to make some vectors. So for vectors, I always search on Freepik, and the ones are free to download. I take them to make designs, and as they are free to download, we just cannot download them and use in our design as they are. We have to do some modifications. So as I told you that I am going to make a detective dog like this. So first of all, I need a dog face like this, and this one is free to download. I am taking this one. Then I need some detective elements. So I was searching like on Freepik, and I am going to use this bundle as this is also free to download. Then I am going to use this bundle and this is also free to download. So I am going to make some combination of some graphics here. So this is the dog face bundle, this is a sunglass bundle I am going to use, this is the detective bundle, and this is the, I am taking this one for this hat. So these are the elements I am going to use in my design. And when we are using designs like this, we need to make sure that everything we are taking is free to download, and then we are modifying them enough to make a unique design, and that is how we can bypass the copyright. And for taking this kind of designs, we can make designs like this for print on demands only, not stock sites. Whoever is working on like Shutterstock, Adobe Stock or Freepik, we cannot just take some graphics from Freepik and upload them on Adobe Stock. That's not the legal way. So for this kind of graphics, first of all, we need to check that if we can combine or convert all of them into a single color graphics like this black graphics. So everything is looking good. Except this hat image. This hat has some white in it. So let's work on this white hat. Like this white. So there is really some tons of different ways to like removing the white from the image. If I click, take my magic wand and click on this white, it will select everything that is in white. We can unite the whites like this, but it will break, sometimes it breaks the vector, that is, so that's why we cannot use it like this. So for using this kind of graphics, we can simply select the graphic like this, then we can use our shape builder to erase the part that we don't want. But when there is a lots of small details in the graphics, okay, first of all, we need to, if we are selecting any graphics like this, we have to check, okay, before selecting, let me go back. So when we are selecting a graphics like this, we need to make sure that everything here is expanded, no strokes in the design. So after that, we can use our shape builder to erase the whites from here. As you can see, this is how we can erase the whites from the graphic, but it will take a little bit of time to remove all the small details from the graphics. So let me do it offline. Okay guys, so as you can see, my white areas are now removed from the hat here. So I can now select everything like this, then convert them into a black color design. So once everything is converted into black, that means there is no other colors in the design and no strokes. Everything is in fill color. So let's just start the design process. I'm going to place the hat on top of my dog here in a suitable size, maybe a bit bigger in like this, then align them center wise so that it stays in a center point, so that is good for us. Then I'm going to select my hat vector here, copy this. I can easily make a offset path for my hat here just like this so that it looks a little better. So let's cut the offset path, select the dog vector, open the transparency, paste in front. This is how it is going to look like. But as you can see, there are some areas that is visible from the empty space of my cat, sorry, the hat. So let's select the hat vector. Then from Pathfinder, merge and unite to make it a complete one single black shape. So that is good for us. But as you can see, there is some little area, like the ear part is visible from here. So let's take our like this pencil tool to just create a shape there, and that area will be hidden. So I need to select everything from here and need to confirm that everything is in black. So that is good for me. This is the final vector for the cat and hat and the dog. So let me group them so that I don't lose their positions. So that is now grouped. Now I need to use my this sunglass here, but as you can see, there are some eyes in the sunglass. I don't want those eyes, so I'm erasing or removing them. Then if I select it, you can see there are small parts in the design. So let's make it unite to make it a complete one single shape. So that is good for us. Now place the sunglass something like this, maybe a bit smaller in size, and then select the vector, align them center wise so that it looks like everything is in center position. That is good for us. Then cut, paste in front so that it will be easily selectable. I will not end up selecting my dog face. I can select the sunglass from here, but I think this area needs a bit to be a bit smaller like this. So that is good for me. Maybe a bit downward like this, that is good. Now I need to select the, okay, I need to maybe make it like this area a little smaller. That is good for me. Now make an offset path for the vector. I am just showing you guys how to modify vectors to make a unique design from modifying or combining 4 or 5, as much as you want, different vectors. So this is now looking like this. That is okay for us. But as you can see, this sunglass is overlapping my hat, but the sunglass should be below my hat. So that is a problem. So let's select our pit bull face, then we'll get the head vector inside the face, and I am selecting the head vector like this without this shape. Then copy this. So once that is copied, I can now select my sunglass vector like this, then open the transparency for that, paste in front. As you can see, this is how the hat will go on top of my sunglass. But as we pasted the sunglass inside this group, so that is why this problem is created. So let's select this group, then select the sunglass vector from here, cut this one, then click here. We need to place that sunglass only on the dog face, not on the hat. So let's double click to select the dog face only, then inside the dog face let's place it, Ctrl F. So as you can see, that is now placed on the dog face, not on the hat. So that is a really, you have to be careful about this, that we don't want to overlap our hat with the sunglass. So as you can see, this is now looking like a detective dog. But I need to do some more stuffs, extra elements like this. I want to make it like he is smoking a pipe. This is the like a detective thing, maybe a bit smaller in size. That is up to you guys how you want to make it. Okay, so I need to place the pipe like this, but I have to make sure that this pipe is going to be in between the lips. So the upper part of this lips, it should be on top of the pipe, and the lower part of this lip, it should be below the pipe. So the easiest way of doing this is selecting them like this, then press shift M for shape builder. Now this area is overlapping my upper lips, so let's erase that part just like this. Then I don't need this part, also don't need this part, this one I also don't need. So that is good for me. Now as you can see, this is looking like the pipe is going below the upper lips. So that is good for me. That will work. And then this smoke, I wanted to use this smoke in my design, but I want this smoke to be like not that much bigger, a bit smaller. But I need to make sure that the smokes is coming inside the pipe face here, then going beyond the, like going behind the dog face. So we will do that, but before that we need to do some adjustment in our pipe vector. This is the open area, we need to close that. So I'm using my direct selection tool here to select this point only. Then if I like increase it to mesh with this part, that is good for me, that is, that will work. So for this area here, the smoke should be on top of this area, but below this area, behind this area. So how to make that? Let's take our smoke, make an offset path for it, just like this, but not that this much bigger, maybe a bit smaller in size. That is good. Then cut it. Now I am selecting my pipe vector here only, then opening the transparency for it, paste in front. So as you can see, this is how it is going to look like. This area is going to like going to be on top of this, this part, this area, but this one should be on top. So I need to erase the anything that is overlapping my this part here, just like this. Maybe a bit like this. Okay, just like this. Then also this area I don't need. This part also should be erased, just like this. So as you can see, this part is looking like on top, but this part is overlapping each other. So let's fix that. So I am selecting my pipe vector again, opening a transparency, sorry, opening the offset path here. Maybe 3 pixels is a bit bigger, 2 pixels for this one. Then okay, cut. And then I am going to select my smoke vector, then open the transparency for it, paste in front. So as you can see, this is how it is looking. It is looking like a messed up, but I need to erase this part because I don't need that. Then this part is looking like on top of my smoke, but here is making some problem. So let's use our eraser tool to fix this area. Just erase like this. You need to understand the transparency very well to make this kind of designs. Now as you can see, this part is looking on top of the other part of my pipe, but this part is looking on top of my smoke, but this is visible from here. That is not good. So let's use our pencil tool to make a shape here, and that will hide the part. So that is good. Clicking here, you can see this is now looking like the smoke is coming from the inside the pipe here. So that is good. Now this area, the smoke should be go beyond the dog face. So that is what I am going to do here. So for making that, I need to first of all select my dog face like this. Only the dog face, not the hat, not the sunglass. Just like this. Okay, 2 pixels a bit smaller, not 10 pixels. Okay, I need to click on this preview. Maybe 5 pixels will work for me, because we used 5 pixels for the smoke. So that is good for me. Then press OK. Cut it. Then I need to click here to select my smoke vector inside the transparency of the smoke. Press Ctrl F to paste that dog face. But as you can see, this area is visible. So I need to select the dog face here, just like this. Then merge and unite to make it a complete one single shape. And as you can see, now the area is invisible. So that is good. So let's, this is the final graphics for us this time. But I want to make this sunglass look like this kind of like a black sunglass. So let's select our sunglass from here. Whatever I am selecting here, I can see in this transparency panel that the, if that is whatever in the left panel, it is the selected object, and whatever inside that, that is the things we pasted inside the transparency. So when I am clicking here, I can see that sunglass is selected right now. So let's press K on the keyboard for bringing the, or you can click to here to go to the live paint bucket. Then once the live paint bucket is activated, we can make the fill color like black, as this is going to be black design. So I am going to fill this two area. Now as you can see, that is destroying the effect we pasted here. We will fix that later, but once that is done, we need to, as we used the live paint bucket, we need to expand it. Otherwise this is one single shape, or if we make any placement move like this, move it like this, it will not look good. So for that we need to select the sunglass and expand it. So once it is expanded, if we double click here, we can select these two shapes separately. Then I can maybe make it a bit opacity, take it down like this, so that my eyes can be a little visible like that. But I want that if I double click here, it will not look very good like a sunglass, it will look like a flat design. So I have to fix that. For fixing that, I need to select this frame only, not these two shape. Again, if I select, press shift and select these two, you can see what is selected here. But if I click here, only the frame is selected. So when my frame is selected, making an offset path for it, 5 pixel, a bit bigger, maybe 3 pixel is good, then cut it. Then I need to select these two shape, make it group like this, open the transparency for them, paste in front. So that will give it a cut out look like this. That is good for me, and this is how it is going to look like. Or then we can, when that is, that effect is made, we can simply select our these two shape to make it like 100%. Okay, we need to select that like this. When that group is selected, we need to make the black. Okay, we make a group here. So that is the reason it is showing, like you can see now it is showing 80%. I can make it 100% like this, and that's how it will look like a full black sunglass. That is good for me. So okay, as we use the live paint bucket that destroyed this effect, but we can fix that. Again, go to the dog face. Inside the transparency, you will find this head vector part. Let's copy this, come back to the surface layer, select the sunglass here, open transparency, paste in front. It will make that same effect again. So that is good, guys. Now the reason I am not erasing anything, I am keeping everything inside the transparency, because I want to add some color in my design, not just like a normal design or something like a black design. I want to make it colorful so that I can use it on like some color backgrounds. So I'm putting these rulers to add some text for this, and the text I'm going to use here, maybe Detective Pitbull. So that is the text I'm going to use here, just like this. I don't know what, if that is right or not. Okay, BU double L's. So that is the, sorry for that, Pitbull, that is the right spelling. So I am selecting these two. Maybe I can use a bolder looking font, maybe this geared slab again. So that is looking good for me. Now breaking the fonts here, again I am going to make it bigger to match the design proportion here. Then this one I am going to make it like this, but I don't want it to overlap with the pipe there, or maybe a bit little smaller like this. Then I can select this too. Sorry, I need to make it move a bit closer to each other, just like this. Then I am going to make it, okay, maybe a bit bigger this time, just like this, so that I need to make this one on top of the pipe and this one below the pipe. So let's select the detective text first, make an offset path for it. 3 pixel is a bit smaller, maybe 5 pixel will work. So that is good, cut it. Now select the pipe here in the transparency, paste in front. It will make this part in on top, and I don't need this part of that transparency, I'm erasing that. So that is looking good. Now I need to select the pipe here. Then I am going to make an offset path for that pipe also, same size, cut. Now I need to select my Pitbull text. then open transparency, paste in front. As you can see, this is how it is looking. Okay, that is looking good. So guys, this is going to be the design for me for this video, but as we are using some kind of 3D graphics, the hat is in 3D, the vector dog face is in 3D, the text is looking like 2D, so I don't like this kind of text. Maybe we can simply make the text a little smaller, then open make offset path for our text, but a bit bigger in size. Okay, I don't want to overlap it with each other, so maybe a bit smaller like this. That is good. Now unite the offset path, cut, then select this text, press Ctrl B to paste it back. Now use your arrow key on keyboard to bring it down like this, maybe a little bit more down. So that is good for me. Now I need to select my original text group again. The same effect I used in my previous video maybe. So that is good. So now it is in 4 pixel. Press OK, unite, then cut, then select my this lower part of the offset path, select the offset path, then press Ctrl F to paste in front, then carefully select this one also, press Alt in your keyboard, then press here in this minus front. It will make a effect like this, and that is the kind of 3D effect. So let's expand it. Now as you can see, this is looking better than previous. So let's use it align together with the with my ruler here. That is good for me. Now also for this one I can use the same effect here. Let's make it a bit smaller, just like this. Cut, paste in back, unite. This unite option is really important guys, because otherwise you will have to select them manually. So again, same size, unite, cut, select the offset path, press Ctrl F to paste in front, again select the offset path, press Alt, click here to make it look like this. So that is good for me. Now select these two group, align them with my ruler. So this area is looking good. Not real. I need to select the pipe here, then inside the pipe I will find that offset path. So let's make it something like this. Maybe we can manually fix this. We don't need to make another offset path for this. That is looking good. So in this area, this is not looking very good. So I need to select my pipe again to make an offset path for it. Maybe a bit bigger in size, just like this. Then cut it, then select the pit bull group. You can see that the previous pipe that you pasted, that is inside here. So let's erase that one. We don't need this. Then press Ctrl F to paste the new one, and that is how it will be fixed. So this is how we can make a 3D looking design. Now you can see the dog face is in 3D, my text is in 3D. Then we can simply use some colors for our design. So let's do that. For the easiest way of adding some colors is, okay, we are first of all going to, I'm going to show you guys two easiest way of coloring. So this is a copy I'm keeping there. That is good for me. Now for this one here, we need to select the main text group here. I'm going to make it yellow, maybe that one. Then we need to select the offset path group, and maybe that one in yellow, but a darker shade of yellow, just like this, so that it looks like a shadow. That is good for us. Then we need to create a rectangle here, but in this yellow. So once that is good, I need to cut this. Then I need to make them a group, like the graphics a group. You can see the dog face, sunglass, hat, smoke pipe, everything is selected. Now I'm making it a group. Then once this is selected, I'm pressing Ctrl B, and that will paste it in the background. Then we have to select this rectangle and this group together. Then we can press Shift M for shape builder, and this will give us this opportunity to erase this part. the extra part that we don't need. If I alt click here, it will erase that part. So as you can see, this is the easiest way of making it a colorful design without having any issue. But as you can see, there is a little problem, but we can fix that easily. Click here to select the pipe, then inside the pipe we can select the transparency of D, copy that, then select the yellow shape. If I click here on the EOL, you can see the EOL is now selected. Open the transparency, paste in front. Okay guys, so as you can see, that area is now fixed. And this is how we can make a colorful version of our design very easily. Then cut it, paste in back to see how it is looking. As you can see, this area is not looking very good. Okay, as you can see, there is a little problem, like if I click here, it will select the... Okay, sorry for that. We need to click here to select the yellow color, and then inside the transparency we need to hide this part. There was a little part of the ear that we draw a shape to hide that, that will be hidden just like this. But as you can see, this area is blending with the black background, so you can select that. Okay, here is a little bit more problem. We can simply go to the group to select the smoke. Here inside the smoke we will find that pitbull face. Copy that, that is good. Now click here to select the yellow. Inside the transparency, paste in front. Okay guys, that is not working because it is making everything invisible here. I don't need that. So we can simply like select the yellow from here, then inside the transparency we can use our pen tool to hide that area. Okay, I don't think this is really necessary guys. Just make something like this. Of course, make it in black, it will be hidden. So that is some advanced tricks to make it look like that. So now if you want to make it visible on black, select the group here, then simply make a offset path for it. Just like this. Okay, 9 pixel is a bit bigger for my graphics here because there is a tons of other elements in the graphics, maybe 3 pixel. Press OK. And then we need to make it a complete one shape. So merge, unite to make it a complete black shape, then cut this one, select the vector group, press Ctrl B2. Paste in back and then select any color you want. It will be in that color. This area is visible, but still you need to fix this area. So I don't think that is a good option to do. So let's not do that. Let's go back to our original design. So that is good. This is one way of making a colorful design. And then if you in this way, this is really hard to put different colors in this design. Like if I want to make this smoke in another color, the pipe in another color. So I'm going to show you guys the other way of making it a colorful design. So for that we need to select everything separately, like the bicat design I did. I'm selecting this hat, then drawing a rectangle here that in same yellow color. Cut this one, select this hat, press Ctrl B2, paste in back, then select the hat again. And then I am going to use shape builder to erase the outer area. That is good. As you can see, this is how we can put the colors there. So let's use our dog face here. Again select a rectangle like this, maybe this one a bit kind of orange. Cut this one, select the dog face, press Ctrl B2, paste in back. Then select the dog face again, press Shift M for shape builder, press Alt to remove the extra part. And as you can see, this is how you can use different color in your design. You can simply select the, okay, for this one here, this pipe and this smoke, we erase this part of the design to like make it fit in our design. And the smoke, there was some problem, like the smoke is not a close path vector, it is like something a open path vector in this area. So for this kind of vectors, the easiest way of making it a colorful design is create a background rectangle like that, then cut it, select the elements that you want, then press Ctrl B to paste in back. Now if I select this one, then we can use the shape builder, but it will erase the area because this is the open path vector. This area is open, this area is open, so we need to like select this part also. This is closing our vector just like this, then press Shift M for shape builder. Then we can use the like erase the unnecessary parts of the design just like this. This will take some time because there is a lots of graphics in our design. Okay guys, so that is not working, this is not working like this. So let's first of all select our these vectors to make them a group like this. Then if I select my rectangle, I can simply use the shape builder to erase anything that we don't want or anything that is going out of our design area, just like this. And then we can simply use some small lines to make some. Okay, as you can see, this is looking good for us, but we want to make it like this pipe in a single color and then this smoke in a single color. Then we need to do like need to create some lines without any stroke or any fill, just like this. So this smoke should be in one color, just like this. Okay, we need to take this one also, press Shift for adding the pointer with this one like this. So you can see this is a line, and then if we select the this orange color and the line here like this, then we can use shape builder Shift M. Then we can, okay guys, that is not working like that because we need to make this line something like this. This is really hard to work with this kind of graphics when, okay, that is not working like that. So we need to do it manually. Like you can draw a shape behind that area, or we can keep this one, this to one color, or then we can like simply use our pen tool to draw a different color from this area, from this area to here. Then just from the area that is just like this inside the black area, then we will have to fix the area that is overlapping our D there. That is also a good way to make it a colorful design. I think this is now wasting just some time, but I hope this will help you guys when you will work with some advanced vector. So let's select this one, make it something, some other color, cut this one. Then I need to paste that for my pipe, so I'm selecting my pipe vector only, then press Ctrl B, it will paste that in the background of that pipe. So that is a way of making it colorful. Then again we can simply click on this pipe to take that D transparency option, copy that. Then again select this group, or maybe this, first of all select this orange color and then select this color to make them a group. Open the transparency, paste in front, it will fix this area. So it will take some more time guys to make it fix like this. Then also for this area we can use like, okay, first of all click here to sample that color, then take your pen tool, just click it like this. Okay, as you can see, we are inside the transparency. So let's cut this one, click here, then select the pipe vector, double click to select the pipe. Once your pipe is selected, just like this, then press Ctrl B, it will paste that color on the back of your pipe, and this is how it will be fixed. And there is some other areas to be fixed like this, but we can do that easily. Like, take your pen tool here. So if you know how to work, guys, it is really easy to work with anything that you want. Okay, there is some more, like these areas also should be fixed. So I need to select my this pipe vector only. Then inside the pipe we will find that a smoke vector that we pasted. So copy this, then select this color, only this color, then open the transparency, paste in front, that will be hidden. Okay, then we need to select this part also, this color, this orange color, open the transparency, paste in front, that area will be fixed. So this is the way of making it colorful, guys. If you are using a closed path vector, then it is really easy to add colors like this, and that is how we can make it a indifferent kind of colors. So let's use the colors for the text also. Then for the shadow, maybe this yellow color, and for this text I'm going to use this color. For the shadow I'm going to use this color. Okay, so that is good for me. Now as you can see, this is how it will look on black. So this is the two way of making it colorful, guys. And then always you can use the live paint bucket. If you just don't want to do this much trouble, just select the black graphics from here. Okay, sorry for that. We need to make a copy here. This is only the black version of our design. Select this one, press K on your keyboard, it will bring the live paint bucket. Then sample any color you want, press it, or fill the area that you want to be colorful like this. Then this one here, just like this. So this is another way of making it colorful, but you have to do it before placing the transparency effect or something like that. So first of all, add some colors in every vector, then start the design process. That will really help you guys to do this easily. I hope this one will give you some idea, guys, how to combine vectors, how to make a unique vectors using some different vector graphics. And that is the way of working when we cannot, like, not every time we are buying some premium vectors from Freepik. So thank you, guys. This is all for today. I hope you enjoyed this one. See you in the next video, guys. Have a great time. Thank you, everyone.